In this video, we'll show you how to install your Deckorators ALX Contemporary Aluminum Railing. Your ALX Contemporary Railing System comes with one pre-assembled panel, four rail brackets, two rail supports, four support brackets, and mounting hardware. You will also need to purchase posts. Get one more than the number of railing sections. Lag screws, four for each post. Be sure they are 5/16 by 4 inches or longer. And you'll need a few tools. A cordless drill, a circular saw or miter saw with a carbide tipped blade, a spirit level, a rubber mallet, an adjustable wrench or socket wrench, tape measure, pencil, and it's always a good idea to wear safety glasses. Begin by calculating how many posts you need. I know I need posts here, here, and here. Luckily, this distance is 12 feet, so I can use 2 6-foot railing sections. This distance is 10 feet 3 inches, so I'll have to custom fit the railing closer to the house. We'll cover that at the end. This is how my posts will be placed. The ALX railing system is available either 8 feet on center or 6 feet on center. My railings are 6 feet on center, so I'll install the posts that way. These posts cannot simply be fastened into the decking. If there is no frame below your post, be sure to add blocking in that spot. Pre-drill your mounting holes with a 15/64 inch drill bit. Then fasten the posts to the deck. Use the self-leveling base plate to plumb the post, then install the post trim by sliding it over the post. Place a protective surface, such as cardboard, underneath your railing to prevent scratching the deck. Using the supplied screws, attach the brackets to the ends of the railing. With 3-inch support blocks in place between the posts, mock up the railing. Mark the bracket holes on both posts with a pencil. Support blocks are needed at 2-foot intervals, so a 6-foot section needs 2 support blocks. Mark the locations for those on the lower rail and the decking. Pre-drill holes on the bottom of the lower rail for the support blocks. Use a 1/8 inch bit. Attach the brackets and then the blocks themselves. Pre-drill the holes for the railing brackets. Use a 3/16 bit for the upper brackets and a 9/64 bit for the lower brackets. Attach the remaining support brackets to the decking. Place the railing between the posts and check for level. Then fasten the brackets to the post. Finish by tapping the post cap onto the post with a rubber mallet. Add your other railing sections the same way. If you need to cut a railing section to fit, begin by setting the post where you need it. Fasten it to the deck the same way. Measure the distance between the posts. In this case, it's 45¾ inches. Subtract that from the length of the railing to get the amount of material you need to remove. Add 1 inch to account for the railing brackets. Then divide that sum by 2, and you'll know how much material to remove from each side. By removing material from each side, the railing section remains symmetrical. In this case, it's 11 7/8 inches. So, we'll go ahead and remove that amount from each side and, whoops, we landed on a baluster. So, we'll move both cuts to the left or right 4 5/8 inches. You can do this if you're going to end up on a baluster or too close to a baluster. After that, simply install the railing the same way as the others. This section will only need 1 support block because it's less than 6 feet. Consider swapping the stock post caps for Deckorators lighted post caps by Hinckley. Go to Deckorators.com to see more.